Welcome back to another video. Today we are going to be doing something new for my channel. We're going to be taking a look at the Tourbox Neo, the ultimate controller for creators. We have a lot to cover, so let's just jump right in. But before we jump right into the review, in the spirit of transparency, I should mention that the Neo was provided to me for free. However, outside of that, Tourbox isn't sponsoring this video and I haven't signed any kind of contract to say anything specific about the Neo. Tourbox did request that I focus my review around how the Neo helps me to work more effectively. And I think that that's the most obvious question to consider when evaluating a device like this. There are a lot of reviews out there of the Neo, but as far as I'm aware, there aren't any that focus on how the Neo works with After Effects specifically. So that is going to be the question that I will attempt to answer. How does the Neo help you to work more effectively in After Effects? Okay, real quickly, let me give you a rundown of what the Neo is and my first impressions. The Neo has a combination of buttons and wheels that you can remap shortcuts to so that it can be used with just about any software that has shortcuts. When I first took the Neo out of the box, I was pleasantly surprised with its build quality. It has a surprising heftiness to it, and it feels solid. The buttons feel nice, the wheels are smooth. Overall, I do think it's a premium device. Setting up the Neo is a breeze. Just download the Tourbox console and plug in your Neo. The Tourbox console comes with some presets pre-installed for some of the more popular creative software. To start using it, just link the presets to the software that you use and then turn on auto switching. That way, when you open up that app, the Tourbox will automatically switch the preset that is linked to that app. You can also download other users' presets on the Tourbox website. There are presets for a wide variety of apps, including our favorite app, After Effects. I test drove that preset and I didn't really feel like it fit my needs, so I decided to create my own to play around with. In fact, you'll be able to download my preset there as well. Creating your own preset is extremely easy to do. To create your preset, click the plus button and give it a name. Then, to start mapping shortcuts, simply press the button on the Neo you want to map, which will highlight it in the console. Then, click on the button in the console, which will open up the settings window. Then, on your keyboard, press the combination of buttons you want to map to that button. Don't forget to give that shortcut a tag, which will save the shortcut. Tagging your shortcuts will be helpful down the road in case you want to reconfigure your setup. Instead of remapping buttons by having to remember all the different shortcut combinations on your keyboard, you can just choose them from the list of tagged shortcuts. This helps to streamline the process of moving shortcuts around to the different buttons. Once you're done mapping all the shortcuts, make sure that you link that preset to your application. I should insert that in order for the app to show up in this list, it has to be open. At least that was my experience. Well, the idea behind the Tourbox is that it's supposed to replace your keyboard and its complicated set of shortcuts. So that's what I tried to do first. I wrote down a list of all my most commonly used shortcuts and I remapped them to my Neo. Then I actually physically removed my keyboard from my desk so that I could focus on working with just the Neo and evaluate it as a keyboard replacement. And it turns out that, drumroll please, I brought back my keyboard. But not because I can't use the Neo without it, but because I like to be able to respond to emails. But also, I wasn't sure if pressing buttons over here was any more efficient than pressing buttons over here. Until one day I had an idea. What if I took the shortcuts that require two hands and remapped them to my Neo? So I wrote down all the shortcuts that I use that require me to use two hands, and a few like page up and page down that require me to either remove my hand from my mouse or venture over to the right side of my keyboard. Then I started to explore some of the other shortcuts I don't use because they require me to use two hands. Ultimately, my goal was to make it so that I don't ever have to pick up my right hand from the mouse. And here are just a few examples of shortcuts that I'm now using on the Neo. Page up and page down. I map these shortcuts to the right and left arrows. I originally tried mapping it to the wheel, but the wheel doesn't have steps in its rotation, so it is hard to rotate clockwise one frame. I personally like pressing a button once to advance one frame. Using the side button in combination with the right and left arrows will shift the layer in either direction one frame. Using this top button in conjunction with the right and left arrows will advance to the next keyframe in either direction. Now, for the up and down arrows on the D-pad, I use those to select the layer above or below my current selection. I found this helpful in situations where I'm trying to select a layer, but another layer's bounding box is in the way. I can use the down arrow until I have selected the desired layer. Using the side button with the up and down arrow will move the selected layer up and down in the layer stack. Using the top button and the up and down arrow will move the selected layer to the very top or the very bottom of the layer stack. I mapped the tall and short buttons to shift the start and end points of the layer. Using the side button with the tall and short buttons will trim the start and end points of the layer. And using the top button with the tall and short buttons will trim the work area. So those are just a few examples of the shortcuts I am now using on my Neo. I haven't really found a good use for the knob, the dial, or the scroll wheel yet. I originally had these mapped to some transform properties, but I found that the performance just was not there, so I scrapped that idea. If you found a good use for those, let me know in the comment section below. Okay, so here's my honest opinion on the practicality of the Neo for After Effects. Can the Neo come in handy for After Effects users? Sure, but that largely depends on how you use it. I'm sure there's someone out there that can either come up with or has come up with a more clever way to implement the Neo into their After Effects workflow. Ultimately, my honest opinion is that if you're looking at the Neo solely for After Effects, I'm not sure that this little device is going to be some kind of breakthrough for you. However, I will say this. If you're like most motion designers and you're working in other apps like Photoshop or Illustrator or Premiere on a regular basis, I do think the utility of this device increases. The Tourbox console has some custom built features for programs like Premiere and Photoshop, which means that the Neo makes sense for those of you who are using those programs. But as for After Effects alone, there are no custom built features, so you are limited to just remapping the shortcuts that already exist for After Effects. Which I think means that for the most part, the Neo doesn't fundamentally change the way you work inside of After Effects to any dramatic degree versus a keyboard. However, I will say that Tourbox has said that macros are coming to the Tourbox console in the near future, so at that point, all of what I just said might change. So I think the biggest question you have to ask yourself is whether or not you could see yourself using this device for more than just After Effects. I might suggest that you take a look at a few other reviews to see if it's a fit for the other programs you use. Links to some of the reviews that I found helpful are in the description. So to wrap up, I just want to say thank you to Tourbox for sending over this neat little device for me to look at and tinker with. And I want to say thank you for their patience in allowing me the proper amount of time to make a real world evaluation of the device. If you found this review helpful, please leave a thumbs up. If you have any other questions about the Neo, hit me up in the comment section below. Also, if you have any tips for using the Neo that I didn't mention in this video, please leave those in the comment section as well. And as always, if you want more videos like this, make sure you're subscribed with the bell notification turned on so that you're alerted when a new video comes out. We'll see you in the next video. Later.